There is something truly special, truly auspicious about eating of a banana leaf.
That's a tasty kara pongal. I think I'm going to have some more of that kara pongal.
ಇದು ನಮ್ದು ಸೌತ್ ಕೆನರಾ ರಸಮ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹುಳಿ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಖಾರ ಸಹ ಇರಬೇಕು. ಸಮ್ ಬೆಲ್ಲ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಜಾಗರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ನೆಸ್.
ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದ ಸ್ವೀಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಟ್ ಹೋಳಿಗೆ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ನುಚ್ಚಿನ ಗೋಧಿ ಪಾಯಸ.
Hi folks, this is Kripalamana Gourmet on the road and I hope you're doing well. In this part of the country, if you're vegetarian and you're feeling festive, you're feeling indulgent, one usually looks forward to savouring a baale ele uta. Or to put it simply, a meal that's served on a banana leaf. There is something truly special, truly auspicious about eating of a banana leaf. And that's exactly the sort of mood I'm in this sunny afternoon here in Nama Bengaluru. So today we've set out to taste a baale ele uta at an establishment that's been around for nearly a century. So join me in this very special vegetarian indulgence.
So we're in Baswangudi in South Bengaluru, and that's where we are headed for lunch, to Udupi Shri Krishna Bhavan that's been around since 1926. Namaskara.
Namaskara.
Nimma hesaru?
Jagdish.
Jagdish. Nivu illi the manager?
Haudu.
So idu nimdu jaga 1926 inda. So the original Udupi Shri Krishna Bhavan is in Balepet, and that opened in 1926. So this place has come up for the last 10 years. So two floors ide illi. Ground floor, first floor, second floor. Baale ele uta illi?
First floor.
So that's where we are headed, to the first floor for the baale ele uta. Baala popular ide. Adu baale ele uta yavagind ide?
Baale ele uta now 2010 indanu ide.
So start nindave ide. So that explains for the popularity of that meal. It's been around for the last 10 years. Just yesterday I had put up a post on our social media handles inquiring for recommendations on popular vegetarian meals. And the Udupi Shri Krishna Bhavan Baale Ele Uta came up as a popular choice, and that's why we are here today. Ali, what's your name?
Ali, Baale Ele Uta ke kadubu aagta ide.
Kadubu?
Kadubu.
Nodabodha?
Nodabodhu.
So they make a special kadubu that goes into the baale ele uta. So that is the batter for the kadubu. Munche ella leaf cup nalli martidira
alla adiga sigalla adag namge illella daily sigalla adrinda cup alli martu
aden jackfruit leaf nalli munche
inond ele barutte
ereka ele
udupi ella sigutte
so typically the kadubu is made in cups that are fashioned of jackfruit leaves. So the batter for the kadubu is basically a combination of the uddana bele, of the urad dal and of the rice rava.
Idu uddu jaasti.
Uddu jaasti?
Rava kadme.
Okay. Andre 70-30 or 60-40 or hege?
70-30.
Ashte eradu?
Ashte ashte.
Mathe idu aaktira, menthe aaktira?
Menthe illa aakalla.
Uppa aaktira solpa? Some salt. So the difference between the kadubu and the typical idli is that the uddana bele is more here.
Correct.
There is more of the lentils to give it that softness. So he's lining the individual tatte or the katoris with some coconut oil. Of course, the coconut oil will ensure that the idli doesn't stick to the container, but will also lend it its aroma, its parimala, its fragrance. Coconut and carrot. So as opposed to a typical idli batter, this is quite held together. As they say in Kannada, gatti ide solpa. And he's also filling it only to a certain point because he wants to allow some space for kadubu to rise as it's being steamed. So So the kadabu has gone into the steamer to be steamed. Next time aagate?
On 15 minutes.
15 minutes aagate. We are now going to the first floor. Take a look at what's cooking in the kitchen here. Actually, the second floor. Namaskara. Hello, sir. Nimdo.
Ganesh. You're the main cook.
Main cook.
South Indian cook.
South Indian cook.
Udupi style ali tumba chenagi
maadtare. Ah.
40 years inda nam jothele.
40 years inda. Yen maadta idira
iga? Iga adige sir. Rasam maadtare.
Rasam. Nandu South Canara Tili Saru. Oh, fantastic. So there's some Tili Saru that he's making now. Nodaboda?
Bani.
So here is arshina, turmeric, asafoetida water, bella, jaggery,
coconut oil,
unse and huli, green chilies, sasve, mustard seeds, jeerige,
tomato,
bari puree maadi hakudu.
Rasam powder.
That's a rasam powder. So this is a rasam powder. This is at the heart of the rasam. So what are you doing here?
Karibevo.
Curry leaves.
Mentia.
Fenugreek, okay.
Jeerige.
Jeerige, okay.
Dhania.
Dhania. Coriander seeds.
Sasve.
Sasve.
Ammele mensu.
Mensu. What mensu use martira? Behadgi mensu. Behadgi mensu. Color chanagi ede, camp color ede. So this is the heart of a rasam. The rasam powder. This is new. So last 40 years in the. So Mr. Ganesh, who is the main adige bhatru here, has been making this rasam powder for the last 40 years. Mate curry leaves ide, bhadgi mention kai. So that's some togri bele that has been cooked and then ground together into a puree. So we're watching the coming together of the South Canara rasam, the Tili Saru. So it's telage, it is quite watery. Adugoskara Tili Saru, that's why it's called Tili Saru. Some coconut oil, mustard seed, sasve, cumin. That cumin and that mustard seed is fluttering away, and that's when the diced tomatoes go in. And some curry leaves. Idalli illa nodide pepper illa illi. The pepper is already there in that rasam powder. Some salt. Ella kaidu alte. He's been doing it for the last 40 years. It's all his kai halte. Some ground tomatoes and some tamarind water. Green chili. It's namdu South Canara rasam nali. Solpa huli irbeko. Solpa sweet irbeko. Solpa kara sa irbeko. Ella equal irbeka. Some bella going in. Some jaggery for the sweetness. So the tomatoes along with the jeerige, the sasve, the curry leaves, the green chili and the tamarind and the jaggery is now boiling away. As he stirs it, as Mr. Ganesh stirs that rasam constantly. And now goes the togri bele. There's a fair bit of water that the lentils or the tuwar dal is cooked in. So it's a tili saru, so therefore they have to make sure it's very tili. It is quite watery. And a little water too. The rasam powder that's going in. And now he's doing the finishing with some coriander. And some hingu water at the end. The hingu water will also ensure that you don't feel gaseous. Salva turmeric. Now that all the ingredients have gone in, all that he needs to do is ensure that it boils away, boils quite well. Now when it comes to the Tili Saru, I was inquiring with Mr. Ganesh here. He says there are different variations. So sometimes when they make the Tili Saru, they also add some coconut milk. Some light coconut milk. So that's a variation. But today he has some coconut oil that's gone in. So that will give it its flavor as well. So that rasam is now ready. Nothing like tasting some rasam that's come just off the stove. So I'm going to find myself a little corner here, lower my mask and taste that rasam. I can certainly smell that rasam powder, I can smell the coriander, some jeerige. This is a rasam that certainly leans towards the saar. You have that spice that you can taste that comes in through the rasam powder. There's some chili that goes into that rasam powder, some green chilies as well. But this is certainly a rasam that leans towards the sour. You have a hint of the sweet that comes in, but as we've seen, there's very little jaggery that goes in. So if you don't like your rasam too sweet, this certainly is a rasam to taste. And what I also find as I'm tasting the rasam is some freshness that comes from some coriander that's gone in. And then the weight of the togri vele. Now that we've seen the rasam being cooked and also tasted it in one corner of this kitchen, time to go down and indulge in the Bale Ele Uta here at Udupi Shri Krishna Bhavan. Namaskara, thank you. So that's an interesting initiative. So if you come here and to hotels that have supported this cause, along with your meal, you can also purchase a token, and that token will be used to feed somebody who's hungry. So this is something interesting. I think this is an initiative of restaurateurs in Bangalore. In the current situation, people are going through tough times, especially those that depend on daily wages for their livelihood. And I guess an initiative like this, Sanchige Ondu, I think will definitely go a long way. So nange 10 tokens kodi. Look for establishments, eateries that are doing this Sanchike Ondu program. You too can feed somebody who is hungry. So do support Sanchike Ondu. Fantastic.
Thank you, sir.
When I went up to take a look at the rasam being made, this place was empty. Well, near empty. 20 minutes later, it's packed. Tells you about the popularity of Udupi Shri Krishna Bhavan and more specifically the Bale Ele Uta. Well, our banana leaf, our Bale Ele is certainly getting loaded with all the dishes. I'm told there are 20 dishes. I think I can count about 10 on the leaf already. So you have that welcome drink, which is the grape juice. That's a delicious grape juice. It's quite pulpy. In fact, you can taste the pulp in this grape juice. I'm told they boil the grapes, perhaps some sugar that goes into it. I think some cardamom too. And then the grape juice with the pulp is blended and chilled before serving. Oh, that's a tasty grape juice. Delicious.
Sir, kadubu.
Kadubu. I think we've got most of our dishes now. We've got the grape juice, the mosuru vade, the nuchina godi paisa, and then of course you have the salt, you have the pickle, you have the kosambri of sorts made with the Bengal gram, chutney which goes with the kadubu, the beetroot palya, there is the cabbage palya, and then of course you have the appada, you have the mensin kai bhaji, that's a millet bisibele bath. I think this is made with a millet called the navade, and then of course you have a lentil holige. And to accompany the puri, you have that sagu that's made of alsande kadu. Time to get down to business. Let's begin with that mosuru vada. Anything fried is tasty, all right. And then when you combine it with some sweet and sour curd, it's a sort of playful flavor and texture that makes you consider tasting another one. But I think we will hold back because we have plenty more to be tasted here. I think we'll go next to the kadubu. That kadubu that we saw being steamed downstairs. So this kadubu is quite soft, and I'm told there's more of the uddina bele or the urad dal that goes in as compared to a regular idli. There's a bit of tartness. They ferment the kadubu batter to the point that it develops that slightly sour twang. So typically when I've eaten the kadubu, that's steamed in that jackfruit leaf and that lends it its own flavor. But out here they use a bit of coconut oil to line that tatte. And I think that coconut oil also imparts a bit of its character to that kadubu. Let's taste this now with that chutney. That's a chutney that certainly is spicy. So it's a coconut, plenty of green chilies, and some coriander and mint. That's a spicy chutney, all right. That kadubu is soft, almost a bit pasty, but with the spicy chutney, it makes for an interesting combination.
There's plenty of green chilies in that one. So I think I'm going to taste only that kadbu by itself, just to cleanse my palate of some of that chili spice. I love the slight grainy bite that I could also taste in that kadbu. I'm not sure if there's some grated coconut that also goes into that batter, but I can certainly taste some grainy bite in the kadbu itself, not from the chutney. That certainly helps, that grape juice. Let's go with that salad or that kosambri that's made of some soaked Bengal gram and some coconuts. There's also that seasoning or some mustard seeds or a sasve. That moist crunch of that coconut is what's providing relief to my taste buds from the chili heat of that spicy chutney. It's a tasty chutney, all right, but a bit too spicy for my palate. The thing with the Bade Ele Uta is that there's so much food on your banana leaf that you really don't know sometimes where to begin. I'm sure there's a method to all this food madness here, but I think it really depends on what you feel like eating. So I felt like tasting some of that grape juice first. That looked very inviting, went for it. Next was the turn of the Masru Vade, and then that kadbu that I watched being steamed downstairs. And now, having tasted that kosambri of sorts with the coconut and the soaked Bengal gram, I feel like eating something hot. And that's where this Mensin Kai Bhaji comes into play. I find the batter a tad salty. Let's go next to that millet bisi bele bath. So I was just asking whether this is a limited meal or an unlimited meal. Well, this is a special meal, so it's an unlimited meal. So they serve you a little bit to begin with, just so that you can get a taste of what's on the banana leaf. And then, depending on what your heart desires, and if you still have the stomach to take it all in, well, go ahead by all means and savor some more. I think let's get to that puri now. That puri combination with that sagu. This is a sagu that's made of alsande kalu or black-eyed lentils with some other vegetables. That's a tasty sagu. You know, but sagu se bola. I think also when you go back for refills, it ensures that you're also tasting hot food. So when the food comes to your banana leaf, it's hot, but then as you spend time over some of the components of your banana leaf, some of the other food cools down a bit. So it's always nice to ask for some replenishment, some hot replenishment. Let's now taste some of that beetroot palya. The beetroot isn't a vegetable that I was too fond of initially, but having tasted a lot of beetroot in recent times, I'm quite beginning to enjoy its fresh crunch. Of course, out here you're tasting plenty of the coconut and the toasted notes of the curry leaf or the karve soppu. Let's go next for that cabbage palya. There's plenty more coconut in this than the cabbage, and I can also spot some flecks of red chilies. Probably some biargi chili that's gone into it. I love the moist crunch of coconut. And out here, they're quite generous in the coconut, whether it's in the chutney, whether it is in the beetroot palya that I tasted earlier, and now that cabbage palya. I always say coconut palya because there's so much coconut in it. Principal, why is this sikboda? Cabbage palya. Well, I couldn't resist some hot puri. The real fun of a puri is when it's piping hot. In fact, so hot that you literally can't hold it. That's when you enjoy the puri the most. Solpa sagu sa kodiga. Some hot puri and hot sagu. Taste that puri now with that cabbage palya. I love the crunch of the fresh coconut in that. The crunch of the cabbage. And then you have flecks of that red chili. Out here the flavors are mellow. The food is a sort that doesn't sit heavy on your stomach. So when they served me all the dishes, I was wondering how I could get past all that. But I've eaten two puris, I've eaten almost everything that's on my banana leaf, and I feel that I can still eat some more.
I think while I wait for my rice, I will park that holy gate to one corner of my banana leaf. So out here, the sweet gets served almost at the beginning, and most people also savor it at the beginning. But in parts of South Canara or in parts of Udupi, where most of the flavors on this banana leaf come from, the sweet is usually savored at the end of the meal. And that's also the sort of mindset that I'm in. So I've got my Nuchina Godi Paisa here and also my Holige. And I'm going to savor this once I'm done with the rice, sambar and the rasam. Some kara pongal now. All that you taste in that kara pongal, the nourishment of the lentils. You're also tasting a bit of the jeerige, some of the cumin, some of the mustard seeds, and some coconut too. That's a tasty kara pongal. I think I'm going to have some more of that kara pongal. There's also a bit of pepper that one bites into. So initially you're tasting the comforting, nourishing flavors of the lentils, and of course some of that jeerige, some of that mustard seeds. As you bite into the pepper, you're tasting a bit of its prickly heat, and that's where that raita comes in handy. First in Bharate?
Rasam
Bharate.
So
we'll make two mounds. One for the rasam and one for the sambar, while I protect my holige. So we've got our rasam first. That anna saru is hot. Anna and tili saru. Sulpa tuppa haakle beko. You may not eat like this at home with ghee on everything, but when you're out indulging in a baale ele uta like this, no harm in stretching that indulgence a wee bit more with that tuppa. That is happiness in a bite. On your palate, you taste the sweet acidity of the tomatoes and then the sourness that comes from the tamarind. The sweetness in this rasam is not too pronounced. So if you're the sort that doesn't fancy your rasam too sweet, this is certainly a rasam that you will enjoy. And what I also appreciate is plenty of the tomatoes whose soft pulp you can bite into. So this is a rasam that leans more towards the sour notes. So if you want to add a bit more spice, I think you can reach for that pickle. Now is also a good time to go for that happada, the rice happada. I thought I was done with the chilli bhaji, but he's got a busy chilli bhaji. I think a chilli bhaji also adds to a bit of the spice that you may perhaps want in a rasam. But as for me, I'm quite happy with its flavors. Rasam done, I think time to welcome the sambar. So the sambar that we have today is a hirekai sambar. I think the rich gourd, if I'm not mistaken.
Sorry,
ghee. Ghee, why not? Why not? So growing up, this was a vegetable that I never enjoyed. I just guess it was the look of that vegetable. I would feel that it would do something to my throat, and that's the excuse that I always gave my mom. But over a period of time, I've come to be more accepting of all vegetables, and therefore this hirekai in the sambar, I'm certainly looking forward to tasting. It still isn't a vegetable that's top of my list. So it's got that nice pulpy inside, but on the outside it does tend to get a bit fibrous, and that's not a texture that I'm a big fan of. But having said that, this is a sambar that's quite enjoyable. I think if you like things a bit spicy, I think the chutney, which I'm still holding on to, can also perhaps come into play. Of course, you have the pickle as well, but then if you like things a bit spicy, I think you can go for that chutney. I love that minty freshness of that chutney. And there's no getting away from its chili heat, from its green chili heat. I think my mom will be very happy if she sees this video of me relishing that hirekai. The trouble though is that I'll be offered plenty of the hirekai when I get back home. And in Namma Bengaluru, no meal finishes without a mosaranna. Of course, I still have my sweet, that holige, and also that Nuchina Godi Paisam that I have saved for the end. Out here, when you're tasting the mosaranna, you're actually biting into the rice. Some places they probably mix the rice and the curds to such an extent that it's almost a puree. But out here, you can still bite into the grains of rice in that masaranna. I've tasted all these dishes, and truth be told, I've not reached a place where I'm feeling stuffed to the gills. I think that speaks for the quality of the food, that speaks for the ingredients that have gone into it. I've tasted the pulpy grape juice, the masur vade, I've tasted the kadbu, the Bengal gram salad, I've tasted the palya, the beetroot palya, the cabbage palya, I've tasted the khara pongal, the rice and rasam, the rice and sambar, and of course not to forget the puri with all that sagu. And I'm not feeling stuffed in the least. On the contrary, I'm feeling quite happy and I'm looking forward to tasting my desserts here. We have some more ghee that's gone on to the holige, also the obbattu as they call it here locally. But in South Canara, it's the holige. And the holige that's made with the lentils, the togri bele. When it came to my banana leaf, that holige was warm and almost flaky. But now it's settled down a bit and also weighed down by plenty of tuppa that's been drizzled over it. Not once, but twice. I think the sweetness of that holige is just right. You have the sweetness of the jaggery, of course, but that's balanced wholesomely with the lentils. And that tuppa also goes to moisten that holige. And if you ask me, my favorite part of a holige is the center that you can almost squeeze into a pasty roundel of sorts. That's delicious. And also quite loaded. Because now I'm beginning to feel that I've eaten a 20 dish bale ele uta. Let's go for some of that. Nuchina Godi Paisa. Let's stir that Nuchina Godi Paisa Mavek. So it's basically wheat flakes stewed in some milk, jaggery. There's also a plump raisin that has soaked up the flavors of the milk and the jaggery. I love the flavor of the cardamom. It's the first thing that greets your palate as you taste the grainy bite of that godi, of the broken wheat. There's also fresh coconut that you bite into, but it's the flavor of the cardamom that reigns supreme in this Nuchina Godi Paisam. I think there's also some lentils that go in just to give it a bit of a bite. So to close our meal, we also have the Bale Harnu with some Bida, the South Canara style Bida. And I think it's only fitting that you close a Bale Ele Uta with a Bale Harnu, a Elakki Bale Harnu. I've enjoyed almost each of the 20 dishes that I tasted on this banana leaf meal here. So a big thank you to all our viewers of Food Lovers TV who pointed us in this direction. You know, I've tasted so many dishes. I've had second, third servings of some. But it's not a meal that's weighing me down. Sometimes you go, you have a big meal and the meal weighs you down unpleasantly. But at the end of this meal, to be honest, I feel quite light and I don't feel sated in the least. And I think that alludes to the care that this establishment takes in the preparation of its food. From its adige bhattas or cooks who've been working here for decades, to the quality of ingredients that go in, to recipes that take you back to South Canara. Well, I've enjoyed my bale ele uta here. I hope you've enjoyed the episode too. Until the next one, stay safe, stay very, very safe, and happy eating.
If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!